It's okay, my dick's small, it doesn't hurt. Howdy, y'all! Give me a drum roll. That's a machine gun, not a drum roll. That's not a...
What?
Drum roll, please! This is the moment that you have all been waiting for, I assume, if you're a fan of Wheel of Mud. The team is... prestige. First off, let's talk about two things. There are two players. I'm gonna let you guys guess to start this out. I got one player that I bought on offense. I got one player I bought on defense. Oh, additionally, I prestiged one player on offense, and I prestiged one player on defense, and I think I'm gonna be throwing some curveballs at you. So take a guess on who you think I bought on offense and who you think I prestiged on offense. Drum roll, please. Bam. So this one was just so obvious. How can you take anybody other than Mike Vick? Mike Vick is undoubtedly the best card in the game right now, and that shows he's the most expensive card in the game right now. 94 speed, crazy throw accuracies, crazy throw power, throw on the run. He's got huge juke and huge spin. That card is godly, and Gunslinger is so good. Now here's the curveball. How do you throw the curveball again? It's like, you put like, I'm trying to think, I used to play baseball. You put the like three fingers like this, and then you go like, and since I can't punch you twice, you have to take your arm and just punch yourself twice. Because you just stared at it, and it was below the belt, and it was above the knee. So good try. No matter what tight end comes out, this was my thought process anyway, no matter what tight end card comes out, even if it's like Ultimate Legend Gronk, it's gonna have like 89 speed. And speed is so important. It'll have better like run blocks and catching traffics, but this Bo Jackson is so good, dude. Like he throws great blocks, he's super strong, he's super fast. That's just an unbeatable card in my books. Drum roll, please. Oh shoot, and if you didn't know guys, last episode was the Mega Prestige. If you haven't watched it, check it out. I wiped all the team other than two players I prestiged and two players I bought. Now, defense. There's one player prestige, obviously, one player I bought. Just kidding, guys. The player I bought was a punter and a kicker. Ready? On to the defense! Ken Houston and Mel Blount. This one, I don't think almost any of you would have guessed Ken. Now, Ken Houston, personally, don't even know who the guy is. I do know, however, that he is an unreal card. I've watched some pro players like literally talk about this guy just being so good and he's just unreal and impossible to stop. 97 play rec, 95 zone, 95 speed, 88 head. Look at him compared to Mel Blount. Now I know it's a cornerback versus a safety, but still, that's just wild. Speed, excel, play rec, tackle, hit power, zone coverage. So I'm excited to see if he can hopefully make some plays for us. Safety is huge, corner is huge. I am scared without having a middle linebacker. I have no user linebacker. Obviously, these will all be filled in with silvers before we start. And then Mel Blount, this is the exact same reasoning with Bo Jackson. No matter what cornerback I get that comes out, like yeah, maybe they could have like 99 speed or something, but they'll never have like the tackle and the hit power and a lot of the stuff that makes Mel Blount such a good corner. The amount of times Mel Blount has come up and hit stick somebody and made them fumble for me is just so awesome. Also, Mel Blount has secure tackler, which is huge. Ken Houston has unfakeable, so you literally can't juke him out. That's awesome. We're just gonna have to fucking run with it, dude. We're just gonna have to do whatever the hell it is we can do to make this team good, but all the exact same rules still apply. So I still gotta spin the challenge wheel to hopefully get 20,000 coins to spend on the team. That would be so huge at the start of this with all these silvers. So I get 20,000 coins to spend on the team. I get two wheel spins and I get a silver lineup other than that. So let's first hop into our wheel spin and then we can move past that. Okay, here we go. Now, before I forget the challenge wheel, because I did forget it on a couple times last time, I cannot forget the challenges wheel. And this is going to be huge, seriously huge for building this team up right now. So I have to spin this. If I complete the challenge of the game, 20,000 coins to spend on the team at the end of the video. Just not fullback touchdown, please. I've gotten that twice. Okay, wait. This could be good. Two field goals. Okay, that's doable. Two field goals. So I have to get two field goals at any point in the game. So this will really suck if it's a close game and I need a touchdown. But if I'm blowing the guy out, I can definitely do two field goals. Okay, so that's out of the way. Let's get into the wheel of... That sounds so sick. Wheel of...
Stop it. Get some help.
If anyone ever roasts you, just say, your mom gay, then say, your mom double gay. And then just say I on your mom. That is for last resort situations only. Do use it sparingly. You will not be friends with that person after that. All right, we got two spins on this wheel. I've added some really, really cool new stuff, but we gotta get it to see if we get it, right? So let's just see what we get to start this one out, and it's gonna be probably two times Legend Fantasy Packs. That one actually is kinda new. It's not one of the super cool new ones, But recently in the store, they've just been like allowing you to always buy Legend Fantasy packs. So, being the smart guy that I am, I've been saving them up. I've actually got 15 here to go through as we do Wheel of Knot. But right here, this Wheel of Spin's gonna give me two of them. So what's really, really nice about this too, is I'll be accumulating some gold players. And gold players are gonna be nice considering like they're only slightly better than silver. So we've already got, of course I get a gold tight end when I already have a tight end. But we do get a 72 cornerback, that'll help out. This is the guy that Kay always sucks this guy's dick, right? Cause he's Asian or something.
That's racist!
Please give me an elite. I've never wanted a base elite so bad. Oh, this is the worst. This is literally like one of the worst cards in the game. Look at how slow he is. Bruh, you are telling me I'm supposed to put this dude at a linebacker with 65 speed? He'll make for a nice DN, but that's buns. So we'll take him. Now this is one of the really important rounds. 84 wide receiver Andre Reed. He's prestigiable to be good, but as of right now, he's kind of ass. Come on, I need good stuff. No, this is not looking to be good. 85 left and a two-tall Jones. And that is so buns. This barely helps me. I could prestige him into the 99, but like, I don't want to get a left end this early. I need a wide receiver. I'm going to have to take this Andre Reed. Like, I have to get at least an okay wide receiver. All right, the gold round, Shaquille Barrett. You're not going to help me. Step into it. It's totally going to help. That's huge. We got another base elite in Darian Stewart. I literally just picked up a free safety, and I'm going to get Darian Stewart here. But this isn't bad. Step into it and Darian Stewart. Two new starters for the team. I like that. Bruce Irvin. He's probably got decent speed. That could be okay. 87 middle linebacker, Jimmy Collins. That's huge. Warren Moon not going to help me. Chris Carter not going to help me. This might be the move right here. I might have just got myself an okay user. 83 speed, or do we go with Jamie Collins, a brand new user middle linebacker. This was a very interesting one right here, but it did add some new starters to the team. And that is only one of two spins that we get. Hopefully we can get a rage quit and some field goals, and we can actually make this team respectable. This one is going to be six series. Let's go. They came out with the brand new 6 series players. And this is a nasty one right here. So I just made it the first on the auction house. I usually have a ton of different ways you can get these players. This one's kind of a basic one. Either way, first one. So whoever's in that top left spot, as soon as I click list, let's do this. 1, 2, 3. Signature series players is gonna be Xavier Rhodes. Holy shit. Damn, so defense is looking, woo! Look at that man right there. 93 speed and a bunch of nines. That's all you need to know. Oh my God, gentlemen, here it is. This is what I was able to scrap together. Here's kind of the game plan. Either get really lucky on a couple of passes, but for the most part, Michael Vick has to make shit happen. As soon as he QB spies me, I feel like I'm gonna be so screwed because TJ Logan can't do shit. I can't get blocks, and I don't know how I'm gonna play defense. Of course we are playing a 95 over. He's got 99 LT, two godly 95s. My top three looks so sick though, I will say that. I'm really scared of his name though. Kill Scam or Kills Cam? I'm really just terrified. In general, I'm just very scared of what's about to happen here. Gotta utilize Bo Jackson too, I can't forget that. Bo Jackson is huge, we get a good one here! And Bo does not make the truck that I needed him to make. That would have been that. 4th and 2. Ah, we gotta go for it, boys. We gotta do it. We can't go scoreless. Not with this team. I'm trying to think back to the start of Wheel of Mud. I don't remember how I won any games. That's a blitz right in the middle of the field. And thanks to Gunslinger Michael Vick, I was actually able to get that off. That's another blitz. I'm just gonna dump this one off to Andre Reed. Andre Reed is gonna take some nice 9 yards. We're gonna keep moving. Okay, so he's on his D-tackle. And he's in a man coverage, so that should be open. Great! Absolute dot from Michael Vick. I am so pumped he uses Michael Vick. Throws a dot to Treggs. Who is Treggs? Who was that?
Irrelevant.
I don't honestly know who that is, but he just threw a great pass to him. We're on the 2-yard line. TJ Logan, do not fumble. I got swallowed up in the backfield, but at least I didn't fumble. I'm honestly kind of excited about that. That's not a blitz. It is a great lane for Michael Vick. The slide in for the quarterback sneak. Woo! That was intense. Now, I would do the kicker flip pass, but I don't know. I usually would do it, but I'm not going to do it today. I'm not feeling that ballsy. I'll just go with my regular PAT. Oh, gosh. All right. 7-2-0. Somehow, we pulled the touchdown out of our ass. No inside zone. I've got this middle left up, and he throws to Mel Blunt. What are you doing, guys? Mel Blunt's just gonna kind of go down easy, but I love you, Mel Blunt. That is why I prestige you. You are so good. Admittedly, though, can you? Oh my God, did we just get a rage quit? I need this so bad, please. Please. I don't want to play this game out. I'm too scared to play this game out.
Yes! Oh my god, we got rage quit!
I'm episode 31. Bro, you just rage quit. You just rage quit to a 78 overall team. With your 95 overall. I'm messaging him. Kills Cam.
I'm just gonna send three of these.
Say that upsets me.
Oh my god, let's go! That's so huge!
You know what I'm gonna do? I'm just gonna make this a big episode. That happened so fast. Like, he quit so fast. I'm gonna make this a big episode. So, here's what we just did. Number one, we just solidified the players we just got. So we got a couple of crappy little golds and silvers here. Or we got a couple crappy golds and elites here and there. Jamie Collins is a nice pickup that we just gotta keep. And for sure, that Xavier Rhodes, that'll probably be with me for the rest of Wheel of Mutt. So that's actually one really good pickup. We also get an additional spin because of the rage quit, which is awesome. And then I'm just going to make this a pretty much a big episode. So I'm going to spin two more times. We're going to act like it's another episode. I'll play again. Technically, that's cheating because I get an extra two spins before the prestige. But, I mean, it's either I cheat right now and do that or I just end the video right now. And I think I know which one you guys would choose. It's you, babe. So I did not complete the challenge because I didn't really have time to. So I do get my rage quit spin, which is going to determine one freebie player that we get to add to the team who will already be locked in. It's going to be a team of the year offense random pack. All right, now I just got to spend another 5 minutes buying these. But once I'm done with this, we get a team of the year offensive random pack. That's going to be huge. Alexa, play Billy by 6ix9ine.
Thank you, Baku, Baku.
Boy, if you don't get...
All right, boys, moment of truth. I've assembled the 15 players, and I've got my random team of the year offensive set reward. I'm not even going to talk about what I could get because I'm only going to get one player. So let's open that shit. I ain't looking at it first, so you got to see it first. Is it a nut or is it a nut? I'm not looking quite yet. I'm looking for my nut button in case it's a nut. I see my nut button. Is it a nut? All right, I'm gonna spin three times. EA is a garbage cup. We're switching up because EA sucks butt. EA... is a garbage company. EA is a garbage company. EA is a garbage company, and that's actually a really good pull, but it's a right guard. Like, actually, like, that's worth a lot because he's a good card if I were to sell him, but I don't need a right guard right now. No matter what, boys, EA wins. Like, even if they suck, they win. I won't complain, I suppose. We'll run to the right side with my TJ Logan now. Great. All right, well, shit, we are not done. So that is the end of technically episode 31, but we're just gonna make it a big episode because I didn't really get to play too much there. So welcome back to episode 31 and a half. We are gonna do our two wheel spins, our challenge wheel, and we're gonna hop right back into everything. Get this first wheel spin out of the way. We're gonna get a top 100 one spin, top 100 one spin, top 100 one spin, bam! Top 100 one spin's really fun. You never know what you're gonna get. You never know what you're gonna get anyway. That was stupid as fuck to say. But let's hope I get a halfback. I need a halfback. I don't wanna even hand TJ Logan the ball. Okay, we're the top 8. 7. Odell Beckham Jr. Oh my god, what a spin. To the left of him though was Ezekiel Elliott. Oh my god, if that had spun just a little. Oh my, to the right of it was Le'Veon Bell. To the left was Zeke. And right down the pipe we get Odell. I can't complain about Odell. That's awesome. So his card's kind of outdated. He didn't really get much, obviously. He didn't. What, was he injured? Yeah, he got injured, didn't he? Either way, his best card here is the NFC Master. It's still got, like, crazy good stats, especially compared to my bum-ass Andre Reed. So, Odell Beckham Jr., I didn't expect to get this. Welcome to the team. Never, welcome to the team. And that leaves us, ladies and gentlemen, with one more spin on ye old wheel of ye old nut. Wheel spin numero dos of episode 31.5. We're calling it episode 31.5. That's what we're gonna do with this. It's gonna be, oh my god, we're getting it again. Looks like we're opening a lot of Legends fantasy packs recently, I'll say that. So we get 2x Legend fantasy packs. I like this because there's a lot of potential, but there's usually no potential. For example, most of the packs I open never get anything, but that one time I pulled the 95 Randy Moss, and that was just like godly. Decent new halfback. Alvin Kamara! Oh my god, and I could prestige him. I have to win this. I have to win this. Alvin Kamara.
Yes!
Let's go. That's huge. Alvin Kamara, let's look at his team of the week stats. 89 speed, let's go. That's huge. I needed that so bad. Huge, it's huge. Mike Vick just got himself some new friends, and no, they're not dogs. Odell Beckham Jr. here at the starting wide receiver. Alvin Kamara here
at halfback. That's huge. Seriously awesome. Zach Martin to help us block up front, I guess. I'll take it. Okay, I have another pack still. I was wondering. I was like, wait, where is he? I feel like there should be other players here. All right, so here's our second legend fantasy pack. Has a new middle linebacker for us. We got another backup middle linebacker. I'll totally take that. And do I need a new right end? No. But I do need... I'll take the D-tack. All right, our next elite round is going to give us a Sammy Watkins. That's pretty big. A Kevin Williams and a Paul Kraus. Do I really want a D-tackle that bad? I don't really care about D-tackles, and Sammy Watkins would be pretty cool. Yeah, we're going to go with Sammy Watkins. We're going to finish that wide receiver core. Odell and Alvin Kamara. Odell, Alvin Kamara, and really that's kind of it. But Odell and Alvin Kamara on the line here. That guy responded. Like, all he said was LOL. He said, oh, he said raged LOL. Okay, he accepted his fate. I appreciate it, sir. No more trash talk for you. Let's win this game. We're already rebuilding the team, and it's only episode 31. What if you had a fully loaded gold RPG with 100, just 100 launcher ammo in Fortnite, and this is the sound it made when you shot it? Oh my god, the top three is so beautiful. Am I going top three? Let's see what he's got. Whoa, that's... this might be an L, boys. He's got a beautiful team, and he's got my master Sean Taylor, which scares the shit out of me. But I'm gonna stay positive. We got this. And before I go anywhere, our challenge wheel, if we can complete the challenge, 20,000 coins to spend. Let's see what we got. Some are easier than others. Like, I get 100 rushing yards, I can totally do that. We're gonna get 200 passing yards. Now, it doesn't sound like a lot when you're talking about Madden, but when quarters are 4 minutes and your teammates start to run the clock, 200 actually is kind of a lot. So 200 passing yards, 20K to spend if I can get it. Let's do this. That doesn't count as a rage quit. I think he actually just, like, lost connection. But that's kind of clutch, because his team is very scary, and I did not want to play him. Oh, we went from one God Squad to another God Squad. Whatever, I don't even... Because we've got Mike, Vic, Mel, Blunt, Ken. Done. And boom! Stefan... Was that Stefan Tuitt? Oh my god, Eli Harold. That was Eli Harold, my 67 overall linebacker. Play action, maybe? Okay, it is definitely a pass. Bumped one man. I'm going up the field, and he's just going to throw a terrible pass. And there's our brand new Ken Houston coming up for the pick. That's why I like to start on defense, boys. We can set the tone with those playmakers we got, and then hopefully our offense can just weed itself out. First and 10, we're going to start with PA deep outs. It looks like he is in a cover 3, so this should work. Nah, it's not going to work gorgeously. Oh, no! Such a bad read. Why would I do that? I just got the ball. I got so hyped that I finally got the ball, and I'm really going to start out the game with that. I'm so upset with myself. Why did I let him lurk me? And Aaron Rodgers can definitely throw a better pass than Bo. So I have to be concerned. Corner strike? Oh, no, it was not corner strike. Come on. We got to come up. What is up with the X button? The X button makes you miss so bad. Now, he's definitely going to be going for this. Anything off that comes right in the middle of the field. Come on. I know you want the middle of the field. Let's go. Turnover on downs, and Bo Jackson was in again. I don't know why he's... I don't even know why he's coming in at all. And that is a blitz. I totally called that out. And we're going to get Odell Beckham Jr. with a nice 20-yard catch. Way to read the defense, Matt. You're reading. All right, we're going to try a little halfback wham. Catch him off guard. Maybe he's thinking pass, and we hit him with a little run. Ooh, Alvin Kamara. What do you know? What did I tell you? He's thinking pass. We hit him with a run. Alvin Kamara in the Steelers jersey. He looks like he doesn't know where the hell he is. But whatever. Now we hit him with the cheese. Now we get out the Gouda. We get out the blue. We get out the Colby Jack. The mozzarella. And we hit him with a little flip pass to really piss him off. Come on, baby. Just get that pass off. Boom. And go up the field. If you go out of bounds, I'll kill you. Autism. That's autism. Just literally catch it and walk. I hate how they do that. Why would you ever run your route directly into out of bounds? That should be 8-0. If I swear to God, if I lose this game by about a field goal, I'll throw hands with somebody. All right, so I do get the ball at half. This is an intense game so far. 6-6. So the user playmakers seem to be the pretty good move on this guy. Oh my God, look at Bo Jackson. And he drops it, of course he does. Dude, come on. It does, and Barry is open in a pocket over here. What? You are kidding me. That was so unbelievably silly. He's just gonna take the underneath pass and Mel Blunt's gonna murder him. I don't know what kind of juke he tried to do, but that was a bizarre one. Yup, I knew you were gonna throw there. Keep running! Jamie Collins, I need you to take him to the house, my friend. Do not let Aaron Rodgers catch you, Jamie. Jamie! Jamie Collins is gonna go home. I'm doing it again. I'm doing the same play, and this time we are gonna connect because I'm not gonna get cheated out of this one. Boom! Bo Jackson! Let's go! That is so funny. Oh my god. Easy money user pick, and I get my redemption on the two-point conversion, and I blocked a PAT. 14-6. EA, you can give him all the picks in the world, but you can't put the ball in the end zone for him, and that's where, okay, maybe you can. Maybe you can put the ball in the end zone for him. It looks like they are gonna put, they almost just literally put the fucking ball in the end zone for him. That's some bullshit. Whatever, dude. 14-6, I am stoked. He is gonna go this field goal here, that'll make it 9-14. Actually, do you think he's, I can't block two kicks, so I'm gonna err on the side of him faking this. Because there's no way in hell I'm gonna block two kicks in a game. So, I'll just play my odds there. 9-14, I'm okay with that. Definitely. Oh, corner strike. He wants the corner strike. Row! No. And it made me drop Mel Blunt on the panic. All right, so he's going to be going for it. Looks like he wants to do the scramble. Let's go! He's going to scramble. Here he comes. All right, 15-14. That's good. Field goal wins the game. Woo! We're just going to let Odell get open. He'll burn his man. Ooh! I totally misread that. That is not a blitz at all, but B's gonna be open there. Whoa! He went so far inside. Dang it, dude. This complicates things a lot. I cannot allow a touchdown here. All right, so he's got a QB spy on me. Look at A, though. Like, he's... And X. Oh, no. You are joking me. What in God's name was that? The guy right in front of him tips it up to himself, and Vic just stands there and watches it while he comes down with it. What the fuck is that, dude? That's the stupidest shit. Khalil Mack at left end, 96. Jarrell Casey. Ndamukong Suh, 97. 94, Von Miller. Pretty much had that one play gone differently, I could have won that game 17-15, ran the clock out. Admittedly though, this kind of works out. I got my players from the first half of the episode and the rage quit, but now I lose my players from the second half. So it's kind of like God telling me you can't quit at Wheel of Mutt. That's what it was. It was God saying you're not allowed to quit at Wheel of Mutt. The players that we either removed is the ones that I just got from that second half of the episode. So Odell is gone. Sammy Watkins is gone. Alvin Kamara's gone. CJ Spiller's gone. This D tackle's gone. We will keep our Zach Martin, our Andre Reed, or Jamie Collins, and the rest of these goobies on defense, plus Xavier Rhodes. That's going to be it for this long episode of Wheel 'Em Up, boys. Thank you for watching, as always. Drop comments and suggestions. I hope you guys are excited for the second half of the season. That's what we're calling this. This is the second half of this. Mike Vick played great. I fucked that game up, man. That sucks. Peace out, boys.